Good evening, everyone. I'm Sharon Reed.
And I'm Steve Savard in for Jasmine Huda. A 21-year-old letter carrier just 2 weeks on the job is in the hospital tonight.
She says she was attacked by a dog that, while delivering the mail, bitten deeply enough to hit bone. That attack happened at a home in the 1600 block of Fernbrook. That's in Florissant. Ray Preston has talked to the letter carrier and her mother. He's live outside the main post office in downtown St. Louis to explain why investigators, Ray, could have a hard time determining just who is responsible.
Right. You know, we also talked with the dog's owner late this afternoon. He says that he has already talked with his attorney. He says he works in construction, travels quite a bit. So he says the dog, which is named Chevy, has been staying with a friend in Florissant since December. Tonight, Chevy, a 2.5-year-old boxer mastiff mix, is under a 10-day quarantine at the animal shelter in Florissant, while 21-year-old Ariel Dixon continues to recover from the attack. She says Saturday afternoon she had just delivered the mail at the house on Fernbrook when the dog grabbed her by the leg.
I have like a hole in the top of my leg and maybe two to three small holes in the back of my leg because they couldn't stitch it up during surgery.
She's got stitches on her arms as well from where she tried to defend herself.
As you can see, that dog pretty much went crazy.
The problem may be more widespread than you think. The Postal Service says last year there were 3,300 dog attacks on letter carriers around the country. There have been 31 in the last 12 months in the St. Louis area.
The pet owner can be liable for medical expenses, surgeries, any expenses incurred due to the attack.
Chevy's owner told us the dog has never attacked anyone, and since Chevy was staying at a friend's house, was out of his control. He's going to try to get his dog back, but must wait until the quarantine period is over. Meanwhile, Dixon's family is at her bedside at the hospital.
How do you think I feel as a parent if you would have seen my baby on the ground crying and screaming for her life?
Now, Dixon says the dog was in the yard last Thursday and was aggressive towards her. She says she used mace on the dog at that time. Now, just who will decide what happens to Chevy? We're working on getting answers on that. We'll have more coming up on News 4 at 6. Reporting live from downtown, Ray Preston, News 4.